This is a comprehensive guide for optimizing Elden Ring on the Radeon 780M GPU. We explore various resolutions and determined ideal settings for a smooth gaming experience. Based on the Steam system recommendations by From Software, we should expect the Radeon 780M GPU to run Elden Ring well. My APU test system using a Ryzen 7 8700G compares favorably against the recommended specs for all components except the GPU, where we come reasonably close. I'm testing with an out-of-the-box configuration, no PBO, no overclocking, and no fancy cooler. But I'm using DDR5 6400 RAM. First, I want to establish a baseline for performance so we know what can be achieved and where we can squeeze better performance or better visuals out of the 780M GPU. So I test resolutions between 720p and 2160p at the gatefront grace. I test every combination of resolution and preset. The gatefront is a good spot because it's demanding and easy to reach. But for our actual settings, we must account for rain and slightly heavier areas, of which there are only a few. We learned that at 720p we can still hit 60 frames per second at high settings, at 900p we can hit 60 on low settings and still achieve over 40fps on high settings at the gate front. At 1080p the APU can't deliver 60fps on any of the presets, but still manages 40fps on high settings. Interestingly, we can still get over 30fps on low to medium settings at 1440p. If you want to test how your system compares, you can use the AMD Adrenaline Performance Overlay, which I'm using here. It comes with the driver, so you don't have to install anything extra. Here they are, my optimized settings. And if you like my approach to testing, don't forget to give a like. Please also note that because of the RAM dependency of the integrated graphics and the possible lower power limits of other systems with the same 780M GPU, performance may be different. So use the method I present in the video to adjust them to your needs. For my 720p 60 settings, I land on a mix of high and maxed out settings. Despite the low res, the game looks attractive, and out of the 6 optimized settings, this is my second favorite one. The 900p 40 setting mostly uses maximum settings, except for shadow quality. I'd only go for this on a sub 1080p screen because the 1080p 40 setting simply delivers better image quality due to the higher resolution. 900p is the highest res I can hit 60fps on my test system. But I have to drop all the settings to the lowest value, except for texture quality. So I prefer the 720p 60 settings. The graphics settings more than make up for the diminished resolution here. For 30fps at 1080p, we can simply max the settings out. I prefer depth of field and motion blur off across all my recommendations. On a 1080p screen, we can use the dynamic super resolution trick to improve visuals further. More on that after this section. 1080p 40fps is my preferred target in Elden Ring for the Radeon 780M GPU. It's a great balance of smoothness, resolution and eye candy settings. Most settings come in at a high preset, however I lower shadow quality to medium because in high it's a bit too tight and won't hit the 40fps cap as reliably as I want. It's pretty impressive that we can get 30fps out of it at 1440p, but I still prefer to run the game at 1080p 40 even on a 1440p screen. But here, we should also enable dynamic resolution scaling to mitigate any possible performance dips. Few people know this, but Elden Ring comes with a built-in dynamic resolution scaler that works really well. But there are two problems. First, they call it Auto Detect Best Rendering Settings in the menu, which is annoying. And second, it exclusively works for a 30fps target. It will only lower the render resolution to prevent the game from dropping below 30fps. It would have been super nice to target 40 or 60fps. But if we are targeting 30fps anyway, we can use this feature to improve our image quality. Essentially, we can get dynamic super sample anti-aliasing, SSAA, by increasing the display resolution to a value higher than our monitor's native resolution, and then enabling detect best rendering settings. If you're not quite sure what it does, just go and try it. But I don't recommend using this on mini PCs or laptops because it will completely max out the APU and use more power and generate more heat and noise. To tune your settings to your machine, first determine your system's performance at the gate front. After picking your desired starting point, test and adjust. Finally, because Elden Ring is so much about consistency and pacing, I recommend capping the frame rate to your desired value. Let me know how these settings work for you and which ones you like best. For more crazy testing, check out these videos here.